Shalom, shalom, shalom. Once again, it's your brother Tazadok, coming at you through the spirit of righteousness and truth. Yo, I just gotta say this for you, know what I mean? I gotta say this before I go into this video. I'm gonna give you some more on the social security number and so on and so forth. But before we go into this, yeah, I gotta say this. Like, you know what I mean? I keep getting emails. And a lot of you are very angry. A lot of you, why are everybody so mad at me, man? You know what I mean? Because I won't help you for free with your commercial presentments or your secured party creditor documents. I mean, I've done that for 3 years. So, you know what I mean? The only thing that bought me was excessive distress and a lot of discontentment with my, time deprived away from my loved ones. So now, you know, yeah, I require a donation. And I just want to say this because I really appreciate those of you that's actually provided donations just simply for the fact of giving. That's real right there. That's real right there. And, you know, I try my darndest to actually send you an email to show my appreciation because, I mean, this actually required extensive research over the years. So, you know, I'm here I am asking for donations, and many of you are getting mad. I mean, check out how ridiculous this is. I got over 10,000 friends or subscribers on YouTube. Now, I got 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. Now, if I ask for a donation of just $1, if each and every one of you just donated $1, you will be helping this channel out tremendously, and you will be actually helping yourself because it actually enables me to spend more of my time doing extensive research and giving you more material that's really effective in your lives if you apply it correctly. So why is everyone so upset with me because I won't do this for free anymore? I mean, every now and again, yeah, I still do like a little pro bono for, you know, some people. And they know who they are. But, you know, I'm back grinding, giving you this information, you know. Oh, yeah, I'm back on my fight game again. Back into, you know, the whole Muay Thai thing, boxing thing. Yo, those of you that are in the area, you can come down to the gym, get it in a little bit. You want to get in the ring? Some of you feel like you want to touch me, you know what I mean? Because I've been getting a lot of threats. If you want to do that, I'm not really that difficult to find. You can find me real easy on YouTube. And instead, you like being out in the street catching a case or something like that, you know? I'll get you a free pass or something into the gym. Come in there, release some of your frustration. You feel like you want to hit me? Come on. I invite that. I love a contact sport. But, I mean, that'll just keep you out of problems because, yeah, hey, might have to sue you after that. But, I mean, if we're doing it in the ring, it's all good. But I'm going to keep it a buck. You know, if you come after me, all of you that's trying to issue me threats, I'm going to come back. I'm still Brooklyn, man. You already know what it is, man. But on another note, this education that I'm giving you is applicable throughout your life if you apply it effectively and correctly. Now, don't be upset with me because I have vision. I have vision. Now, I mean, I do not like engaging in polemics. If you are a polemics extraordinaire, I'm going to terminate that relationship with you. So many of you have been getting blocked. You send me, like, a lot of messages like this, really emotional. You know what I mean? Kind of remind me, you know, of my ribs sometimes. You get, like, you know, real emotional. So, I mean, if you trying to engage in a relationship with me where there's a lot of polemics, I'm going to dismiss that relationship. And then, you know, some of you, I mean, I hear many of you, you know, you're having problems out there in your relationships with your wives and so on and so forth. I mean, you brothers are changing, man. Guys are becoming more feminine and females, and I'm going to get into the video, but I got to say this. Females are becoming far too masculine. And a lot of females, your minds are being actually manipulated and controlled by what you see in the media and on TV. So where your relationship may have worked otherwise, it's not working because you're measuring it based upon what you see in the media. Oh, girl, you should leave him. You shouldn't be with him anymore. And then a lot of you dudes, man, they got you out there buying candy, chocolate, all of this. Got you out there slow dancing to damn love songs and all, trying to win her over when you're supposed to be the prize. You know what I mean? If you really want to go, she want to go. Why are you banging her to stay with you? Let her go. You know, you out there crying like a bitch. How do you respect someone weak like that? So I'm just not built like that, man. Somebody want to leave me, go ahead. I'm going to be all right. Because, you know what I mean? Because if you depart from me, you're going to have to settle for less. Because you're leaving the best. You know what I mean? I know some of you might not like that, but I mean, you're leaving the best. I'm a different kind of dude. It's really exceedingly difficult to replace a dude like me. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm not being like headstrong or anything. I'm just keeping it a buck. I'm keeping it real with you. To those of you in the street, you know what I'm talking about. I'm keeping it on it. So, I mean, if she want to leave, let her leave. Go ahead and leave. I'm going to be all right. It's far too easy for me to replace that. So, many of you need to man up. Oh, Todd the dog, you don't understand, man. She's different. That's why you mess it up. you got your mind fixated on, like, this woman is so different. That is blowing your mind, and now you've lost your masculine characteristics. Now, I ain't no perfect dude. You understand what I'm saying? I got my fallacies, but hey, I'm a different dude right now. I clean myself up. You know what I mean? I'm operating from a different, you know, aura. You know, I'm operating from a different standpoint. I look within myself and cleared up all of my fallacies. I'm not the same dude that I was like 3 weeks ago. You know what I mean? I'm different. And that's what you got to do. But you guys got to first man up. Stop trying to buy the woman chocolate and so on and so forth. And out there begging, baby, please come home. Man, if I was close to you, I'd smack you, man. And then if you wanted to do something about it, I'd ask you to step in the ring. We could settle with that where you get your frustration over after I finish beating and kicking the last bit of bitch out of you, then you might be alright. See, I have to keep it real with you for a minute, man. I'm giving it to you real right now. So, you know, to all of you guys out there, you got your feelings crushed by your rib, your wife, and you know, now you don't want to do nothing. You don't want to go out, be with your friends and nothing. Man up, man. Man up. Be a man. And she might respect you a little more. You understand what I'm saying? So I just wanted to bring that out. But all of you that sending me all these crazy emails, oh, Taza dog, you should help me. If you was real, you would do this for free. Free? I can't remember anyone helping me. When I was out there messed up, you know what I mean? Nobody helped me. Ain't nobody never gave me anything for free, man. I'm giving you energy. I'm giving you research. I'm giving you education. So I'm just asking those of you, subscribers, that could find it in your heart, just donate. If you could only donate $1. Donate $1, but show some appreciation for my time and energy. But enough of that. We're gonna go into this video. But before I go into this video, since so many people been hitting me up about their relationships, I'm gonna talk a little bit about marriages and interpersonal relationships and so on and so forth. And then we're gonna go into part 4 of this series. Of videos living without the social security number. So let's get into it. And yo, man, you guys out there, stand up and be a man. Be a man, man. Man up. You might get your wife back. Or you might find something better. But remember, the Heavenly Father joined to join you together. So, you know, try and work that thing out. Then if she want to leave, let her step. Be a man. So let's get into this video.
Shalom, shalom.
Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice of your brother, Tazer Doc. And I'm going to continue on with this series of videos now that I've actually been doing over the past of the past couple of weeks or so, week and a half. Living without the Social Security number. Life without a Social Security number. I am in no way suggesting that you live without a Social Security number. I'm just providing information and education. Everything that I provide to you is for educational, informational, and for some of you, entertainment purposes only. Are you not entertained? So, as usual, I wanted to say what I'm about to provide is not legal advice. I did not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourselves a competent counsel, and then please, please be advised. What I'm about to provide is for educational, informational, entertainment purposes only. Now, prior to going into the video, I've been contacted by several different people, and you're actually undergoing some difficulties in your lives. One thing that I want to say prior to actually going into this life without a Social Security number is that if you learn this, what I'm about to teach you, if you learn this, you will be unstoppable. You will be unstoppable. Not really impregnable, but unstoppable. Now, what I'm about to teach you, and I encourage you to listen to this video in its entirety at least 10 times. Again, as I always state, repetition is the father of learning. So you need to watch this repetitiously. Now, out of this situation, I want you to say, henceforth, any kind of situation, despite whatever type of problems you may be having throughout the course of your lives, you may have actually suffered a foreclosure. You may have suffered excessive driving without a driver's license. You may have suffered the loss of a loved one. You may have actually just recently undergone a divorce or a separation. But what I need you to do right now is to repeat to yourselves is that out of this situation, only good will come. You see, your thoughts, brothers and sisters, ladies, men, is key to your thinking. Your thoughts is key to your thinking. Your thoughts make you. They determine who you are. So it is important to fill each day of your life, of our lives, with as much enjoyment and benefit as possible. And that's actually essentially controlled by your thoughts. Now, at some time in the future, your lives or your lives in the physical is going to end. So you better cherish today before it passed away. So you should be enjoying life as much as possible right now. Is that correct? So don't be discouraged by the loss of material things or the loss of someone that may have decided to leave your life. Don't feel depressed and be down. Be joyful and learn that out of this situation, only good will come. You'll replace them or it with something or someone better. Con? So brothers and sisters, since we know that at some point our lives in the physical is going to end, we better make the best out of today. Because you're not promised tomorrow. So everything that you do, understand this, it produces a cause and an effect. So what I'm about to give you, what I'm about to teach you, is imperative to that cause and effect and you enjoying life. I'm about to teach you something that you will actually change your reality with if you adhere to this message, but not just your material reality, but your spiritual and your emotional reality and your feelings as well.
So I want you to listen carefully. Listen carefully. So from this moment forth, I want you to take full responsibility for everything that happens as a result of your actions. See, many of us have a tendency to blame others. We want to blame others. We're angry with others. Is that right? And we never want to look internally. We never want to look at self. But from this moment forth, if you want to alter your life, if you want to change your life, from this moment forth, I want you to take full responsibility of everything that happens as a result of your actions. Now, I mean everything that happens. Lost of your home, lost of a job, lost of your spouse in a marriage that went bad. Well, I want you to stop pointing the finger and take full responsibility of your actions. Of your actions. Stop blaming the others. So, when you do this, brothers and sisters, and the reason that I'm suggesting that you do this is because when you do this, you will discover what it is that you did to actually cause the results of your situation. Only when you take actions for your responsibilities. So you will discover what it is that you did to cause the results of your experience. So people that continue to blame others and, you know, for their undesirable circumstances and their undesirable experiences remain blind to their true causes in that fallacies or these fallacies that exist within themselves, because they keep looking outside of themselves, attempting to blame others. Understand that. Understand that. So you must first look within and stop blaming others. So if your experience is an undesirable situation, or you just recently experienced an undesirable situation, home went into foreclosure, the car got repossessed, your spouse left, or you left your spouse. If you experienced an undesirable situation, you know, and undesirable results, then I need you to put these words into your mind when you think about that particular situation. I am responsible. Don't blame anyone else. Oh, so-and-so, yeah, he done this, or she done this, or the de facto done this. No, say, I am responsible. I am responsible. You must repeat that in your mind. This actually prevents you from looking outside of yourself and consistently trying to blame others. You must determine what you did, brothers, sisters, that actually contributed to the undesirable circumstances or results. Then you must actually make those changes required to produce a positive benefit. Do you understand? Do you understand? If you follow this, you can't go wrong. You can't go wrong. So it could be a marriage. It could be your home going into foreclosure. It could be your car is repossessed. It could be the loss of a job. And so on and so forth. Whatever it may be, brothers and sisters, you must take responsibility. And you must ask yourself, how did I cater to these undesirable results? Do you understand? Do you understand? So it could be the loss of something. It could be the loss of someone. It could be failure to submit documents or so on and so forth. You know, in the particular situation, you know, a commercial presentment and so on and so forth. Whatever it is, you must assume responsibility and stop blaming others. Then a change will come. So, and understand this. I cannot overemphasize this. What is done in the past cannot be changed. You can actually not go back to the past and change something that was done. So stop blaming yourself and blaming someone else about their past actions. Hey, I have to learn that. You need to learn that. And as soon as you learn that, you will relieve yourself of a tremendous burden and you will be free. Free to be yourself. You will learn to love yourself. So, you actually use these lessons that, you know, you use these past experiences that you've actually experienced as lessons learned as the foundations for the actions that you would actually take to avoid loss in the future, to avoid, you know, losing these benefits in the future. So this will actually enable you in your mind to actually be free. So you got to free your mind of, you know, these feelings that you have of resentment or revenge. Oh, I'm going to pay so-and-so back. They shouldn't have done me like that. No, brother. No, sister. You got to free yourself of those thoughts. You must cleanse your mind. You must cleanse your mind. You must forgive them. You must forgive yourself. And then, respectfully, move on. You'll be free. So this would actually enable you to cleanse your mind. You know, of feelings of revenge, regret, resentment, and all the negativity, all the negative thoughts. So only then will your mind, only then after you do this, will your mind be free to focus on what is instead of what has been, which you could actually not change. You can't go back in the past and change something that actually has been. So do not allow any negative thoughts of the past to fill your mind. You actually must replace them with the words, "It is forgiven. It is forgiven." Yeah. Tons of dog done me wrong, but hey, it is forgiven. Yeah. He done me wrong or she done me wrong, but hey, in your mind you must tell yourself it is forgiven. Because as long as you hold on to those feelings of resentment and regret, that's gonna pull weigh you down like an albatross. So consider this. Those who allow themselves to become emotionally upset, because many of you are controlled by your emotions and you make harsh, unrational decisions that you're sorry for later because of your emotions, especially the emotion of anger. You make irrational decisions when you're within the heat of emotions. Now, women do this more often than men, but many of you men go into bitch mode. And you're just as emotional as some females. So you must resist the urge to do things that cause short-term benefits, or short-term personal benefits for you. Well, you feel real good about that. You feel real good about hurting someone. Or I feel real good. Oh, I'm going to show him. That's emotional, though. That's emotional, sis. That's emotional, brother. So you must resist this urge to yield to your short-term personal benefits when you're reacting out of emotions that would actually cause a long-term damage or a long-term loss in your life. Because of your irrational behaviors, you might lose your spouse. Because of your irrational behaviors, you might lose your home. Because of your irrational behaviors, you might lose your car and lose your way, and in long term you'd be much sorry for it later and be like, well, why did I do that? But because you were thinking emotional. So by doing things that would actually increase your personal, you know, by just not making these emotional decisions, you would actually do things that would actually increase your personal respect, and it would actually cause others to respect you more personally. Because, you know, emotions distort your thinking. So when you give in to temptations, the temptation of becoming angry, the temptation of, you know, spending that money when you know you didn't have it to spend, when you actually should have paid your rent or your bill. Or you give into the temptation of, well, I'll show him or I'll show her, I'm going to divorce him. When you yield to that temptation, brothers and sisters, husbands and wives, when you yield to that temptation, it's, you know, your emotions manipulating you instead of you controlling your emotions. You're being actually controlled by your emotions when you give into temptations. You give up the control of yourself to that which is actually tempting you. So if you begin to feel yourself or yourselves tempted to do something that would actually cause an undesirable circumstance or an undesirable long-term loss, then you must say to yourself, I choose not to do this. Yeah, I could get angry right now, but I choose not to do this. Yeah, I could divorce her, but I choose not to do this. Why? Because you're making irrational decisions under the heat of emotions. And some people never learn this. So in long term, it costs them their loved ones, their marriages forever. This is why approximately 65% of all marriages now end up in divorce. Making decisions under the heat of emotions without thinking it out. But I'm giving you right knowledge. And if you take this, this will change your lives forever. And your relationships, be it your marriage, your relationships with personal friends, your work relationships, all of your interpersonal relationships will thereby improve. And you could take it or let it alone. So you must say to yourself, I choose not to do this. I choose not to run away. Oh, I'm not going to spend the night away from home. No, I'm not going to run away from the situation. Yeah, I mean, because it's easy to flee, but then that might cost you in the long term. So be it if, you know, you're tempted by some other person, you know, you're going through a situation with your spouse, and then there Satan comes through the form of another person treating you really nice, trying to entice you to commit adultery. Don't yield to that temptation. Or you might be tempted to want some material thing that you've been actually lusting for a while, and instead of paying your bills or paying your rent, you purchase the material thing and then your family suffers. Do not yield to the temptation, folks. I'm being very serious right now, because the long-term effects of that may cost you your loved ones, may cost you everything, and you may suffer from that effect for the remainder of your lives. Do you understand? I'm giving it to you 100%. I'm keeping it a buck right now. I'm keeping it 100 with you. So I highly encourage you to listen to what your brother's telling you. So, brothers, sisters, you know, another thing, if you're affiliated with toxic people, that's going to actually encourage you to yield to certain temptation. Oh, go ahead, girl. I know you're tired of going back and forth with him. When you look at most of those people's lives, they're extremely miserable. What a guy. Oh, go ahead, man. But forget about her, so on and so forth. You know, you look into his life. How is his marriage going? Is he even married? See, most of these people that's going to give you this bad advice, I don't even care if it's your mother or your father, but they're telling you to do something that's contrary to the laws of the Heavenly Father, or to abandon your spouse, you better not yield to it. Because the Heavenly Father is going to deal with you in the end. Don't yield to the temptation. Just think of the hardships and the losses that you will actually experience after you give in to that temptation. You go and you spend a night away from home. Look at the hardship that it's going to cause in your marriage. Now you're going to create distrust. You're going to create the thoughts in your spouse's mind. I wonder if they committed adultery on me, and so on and so forth. Don't yield to the temptation. You go out, you gamble up the money that was supposed to be spent on your family. Don't yield to the temptation, brothers and sisters. Don't yield to the temptation. So you got to remember right now, enjoy your lives. You're only here for a short time. So enjoy your lives. You know, I tell myself, hey, I'm only here for a short amount of time, and I'm not here to suffer. I'm not here to suffer through it. So, each and every day, I strive to enjoy my life, and I'm enjoying it. I'm not going to let anyone ruin my day, and I would highly encourage you to take that same idea and reflect upon it. Now, you must remain, before I get into this topic, I'm not going to be much more longer. I've already been going into this like 20-some minutes, but I feel it's imperative because a lot of people has actually been contacting me and they're having problems in their relationships. So I felt that this was actually essential to speak on that, be it an interpersonal relationship, intimate relationship, or relationship with governmental entities. So you must remain patient, brothers and sisters, in the lack of progress. Sometimes you're doing something and you're not progressing, but you must remain patient. Don't get impatient in the lack of progress. If there is no progress, then you must take the correct actions for progression to come. Do you understand? You might be trying to process certain paperwork, but you haven't been taking the appropriate actions. So you must take the appropriate actions for progression to come. Right now, some of you under the sounds of my voice, this is going to prevent you from getting a divorce in your marriage. The Heavenly Father put the Spirit on me to send you this message. So you got to take the appropriate actions for progressions to come. Don't waste time complaining about problems. Don't waste time complaining about the past. It's not real anymore. Your focus should be on coming up with a solution to the problem. When your mind starts to go back, well, so-and-so done this to me, and so-and-so done this to me in the past. See, you're focusing on the problem instead of a solution to the problem. You know, when that comes into your mind, your thought process should be, I change to gain. I change to gain. You got to repeat that to yourself. I change to gain. You're changing for the better. You're focusing on positive thoughts. Now, if you lose concentration on thinking positively, then you must say, I'm concentrating on what will be the future benefits. I'm concentrating on what's going to be the future benefit of this? So you got to focus on the positive thoughts and rid yourself of the negative thoughts. Focus on the future benefit of enduring struggle. Focus on the future benefit of enduring, you know, the problems in your interpersonal relationships. So, and if you feel like giving up on an obligation, you know, sadly enough, brothers and sisters, many of our people and people in general are just getting divorced. Commitment means nothing to people anymore. Marriage means nothing to people anymore. There's a lot of people, they're still married, they have a contract with you in a contract with the Most High that they'll go out and have commit adultery with someone else. So to these kind of people, and these are unhonorable people, commitment means nothing anymore. And the Heavenly Father is going to judge you for that. So, brothers and sisters, if you find yourself in these particular situations, if you're tempted to do something unjustly, to go out and commit adultery on your spouse, to be enticed by someone else, first of all, you should be with your spouse, working it out, you know. But if you feel like giving up on an obligation, on your marriage, on any kind of contract that you've actually involved yourself in, on a task that you're striving to do to make yourself better, you must say to yourself, I keep my commitments. I keep my commitments. Khan, yasha'Allah, keep your commitments. Did you not take a vow for better or for worse? Keep your commitment. Push through it. Work it out. Keep your commitment to your spouse. Keep your commitment to the Heavenly Father. Now, if you are tempted to unjustly break your commitment to your spouse, to whoever you committed to in a contract, to the Most High, you know, you got to repeat to yourself, I keep my commitment. I keep my commitment. That thought must come into your mind. I keep my commitment. And brothers and sisters, avoid arguments by, you know, reinforcing or not participating in heated conversations, just by reinforcing positive things about that particular situation. So whatever situation that you're going through, brothers and sisters, again, I want you to repeat to yourselves, out of this situation, only good will come. No matter how difficult you may think it will be, the Heavenly Father could bring you out of it. Now, with that being said, I'm not going to be much longer, but I want to go into this living on fight of social security. I'm going to touch on this a little bit. I'm going to have to continue it on in another video. So, the Lord protects the employer. That's what I want to say in this video, going into this living on fight of social security number. Now, the federal law requires employers to request a social security number from payees, employees, or contractors. Con? True indeed. So there is no federal law actually requiring this disclosure. How many of you knew that? There is no federal law actually requiring this disclosure as a condition of employment or contract, and there is no penalty for failing to obtain this disclosure, 26 CFR 301-6109-1C. It actually prescribes the procedures that an employer must follow. So this regulation, brothers and sisters, require a prior to, it requires a payer to request disclosure of the identifying number. So if the disclosure is refused, a second request must be made stating that the disclosure is required by federal law, even though it is not required by federal law. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? So if the disclosure is refused a second time, the payer must actually attach an affidavit to the form needing the Social Security number stating that the requirement for the request and disclosure has been met. No federal or state law imposes any penalty for not obtaining disclosure of a Social Security number as a condition of employment. Do you understand what I just said to you? Now, rewind that part of the video back. I want to make sure that you understood that. Now, 26 U.S.C. 6723 provides that a penalty of $50 shall actually be assessed for each failure to comply with the reporting requirement. However, 26 U.S.C. 6724 provides that for a waiver of any penalties assessed under the code upon showing of reasonable cause, section 6274 alpha. provides. And, of course, I quote, no penalty shall be imposed under the part with respect to any failure if it is shown that such failure is due to reasonable cause and willful neglect. 26 U.S.C. 6724 Alpha. Now, there is a prudent that a business developed proof that it actually has complied with the requirements to ask an employee for and was unable to obtain a social security number. So the following form that I'm about to mention should be given to the employee for his signature. It is known as a P-1 form, which is also referred to as a reasonable cause affidavit by payer. So, you could kindly ask the employer for a P-1 form. Am I suggesting that you ask this? I said, no, you can't. So, an employer should actually attach a copy that, you know, of this P-1 form completed from this completed form to your business tax return. So as far as complying with Internal Revenue Service Form W-4, most employment policies require that each employee complete an Internal Revenue Service W-4 form before the employee can begin work. Now I'm going to show you how to deal with that. And if I forgot to mention, if you find this video to be of value, please click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this video to be worth. How much value was it to you? $300, $200, $100, $50, $1. Nevertheless, donate whatever value you may find it to be worth. And if you're interested in becoming a secured party creditor, the email link below, creditorsdebtorscontracts@yahoo.com. Contact me and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. So, now back to the subject at hand. So, they actually incorrectly believe that 26 U.S.C. 3402 actually requires employees to complete a Form W-4. Now, specifically, they refer to the notice on the lower back of the form 26 U.S.C. 3402 F 2 A. So 26 U.S.C. 3402, income tax collected at source, a requirement of withholding. Number one, in general, except as otherwise provided in this section, every employer making payment of wages shall deduct and withhold upon such wages a tax determined in accordance with F, withholding exemptions. 2, exemption certificates. A, on commencement of employment or on behalf on before the date of the commence of employment with an employer. The employee shall furnish the employer with a signed withholding exemption certificate relating to the number of withholding exemptions which he claims, which shall in no event exceed the number which he is entitled. So this requirement, brothers and sisters, is implemented in regulations at 26 CFR 31.3402F2-1. Might I cite that to you? 26 CFR 31.3402 F2-1, withholding exemptions certificates. On commencement of employment, on or before the date on which an individual commences employment with an employer, the individual shall furnish the employer with a signed withholding exemption certificate relating to his marital status and the number of withholding exemptions which he claims, which number shall in no event exceed the number to which he is entitled. If the statement describes in section 31, 3402, November-1 are true with respect to an individual, he may furnish his employer with a signed withholding exemption certificate which contains such statements. For form and content of such certificate, see Section 313402F5-1. The employer is required to request withholding exemption certificate from each employee, but if the employee fails to furnish such certificate, such employee shall be considered as a single person claiming no withholding exemptions. Now, brothers and sisters, now that I've actually outlined the basic Internal Revenue Service requirement, why don't we have a look at this a little closer, where it is stated. Notice that, I want you to take note, that 26 U.S.C. 3402A1 defines that application of this section by stating except as otherwise provided in this section. And I want you to notice that 26 CFR 3104-02 Foxtrot 2-1 states the employer is required to request a withholding exemption certificate form from each employee, but if the employee fails to furnish such certificate, blase, blase. So you see, the phrase, if the employee fails to furnish such certificate, means that an employee may decline to provide the W-4 form. Do you understand? Do you understand? I want you to take note that it also states such employee should be considered as a single claiming no withholding exemptions. And I'll discuss that a little later. So understand that if the form W-4 employees withholding allowance certificate were absolute required for each employee, it would specify that. If it were without exception as an absolute legally required mandate, then why is the employer required to ask for it? And why must the employee furnish it? So if it were clearly required, the law would simply direct the employer to do the withholding without exceptions. Do you understand? So, brothers, sisters, this argument usually continues with the assertion that the regulation also provides such employee shall be considered a single person claiming no withholding exemptions. But the counter to the assertion is to clarify what is actually written. So the phrase shall be considered as does not authorize the actual withholding of money, or what they refer to as money, fiat currency. Do you understand? So it simply tells the employer how to think about this portion. So the authorization for withholding comes only with a properly completed and signed W-4 agreement. Do you understand? Now, with that being said, before I close this out, I want to let you know that the form W-4 is actually a voluntary withholding agreement. So the reason that an employee might fail to furnish such certificate is that 26 U.S.C. 3402 Alpha 1, which actually defines the application of this entire section, states that exception as otherwise provided in this section. So while reading further on in the section, one actually finds out the otherwise provided is actually explained in 26 CFR 313402-PAPA-1. But don't believe me, as I always tell you, go and check it out for yourselves. Go and check it out for yourself. So where it actually explains that the W-4 form is a voluntary withholding agreement and its completion is not required by law. Oh, no, Tazi Dog, I don't believe that. You're making that up. No, I don't believe that. I've been passed. Go and check it out for yourselves. 26 CFR 31-3402 P-1 Voluntary Withholding Agreement. And it states in A, in general, an employee and his employer may enter into an agreement, under Section 3402 Bravo to provide for withholding for income tax upon payment of automatic described in paragraph B1, Section 31.3401A3, made after December the 31st, 1970. An agreement may be entered into under this section only with respect to amounts which are includable in the gross income of the employee under Section 61 and must be applicable to all such amounts paid by the employer to the employee. The amount to be withheld pursuant to the agreement under Section 3402 Papa shall be determined under the rules contained in Section 3402 and the regulations thereunder. See Section 313405C-1. Question and answers. 3. Concerning an agreement to have more than 20% federal income tax withheld from eligible rollover distributions within meaning of Section 402. Section B says, form and duration of agreement. Except as provided in subdivision of this subparagraph, an employee who actually desires to enter into an agreement under Section 3402, Papa shall furnish his employer with a W-4 withholding exempting certificate executed in accordance with the provisions of Section 3402 Foxtrot and the regulations thereunder. The furnishing of such W-4 shall constitute a request for withholding. In the case of the employee who desires to enter into an agreement under Section 3402 Papa with the employer, if the employee performs services in addition to those to be the subject of the agreement, then the unenumeration for which is subject mandatory income tax withholding by such employer, or if the employee wishes to specify that the agreement terminate on a specific date. If the employee shall furnish the employer with a request for withholding, which shall be signed by the employee and shall contain A, the name, address, social security number of the employee making the request, the name, address of the employer, a statement of the employee desires withholding of federal income tax and applicable of qualified state individual income tax, see Section D3-1 of Section 301-6361-1 of this chapter, regulations on procedures and administration. And D, if the employee desires that the agreement terminate on a specific date, that the date of the termination of the agreement. So, if accepted by the employer, as provided in Section 3 of the subparagraph, the request shall be attached to constitute part of the employee's form W-4. So, an employee who furnishes his employer a request for withholding under the subdivision shall also furnish such employer with the W-4. If such employees do not already have a W-4 in effect with such employer. Do you understand? Section 4 says no request for withholding under Section 3402P shall be effective as an agreement between an employer or employees until the employer accepts the request by the commencing to withholding form the amount with respect which the request was made. Part 2 says, an agreement under Section 3402 Papa shall be effective for such periods as the employer and the employee mutually agree upon. So, however, either the employer or the employee may terminate the agreement prior to the end of such period. Do you understand? By furnishing a signed written notice to the other, unless the employer or the employee agrees to an early termination date, the notice shall be effective with respect to the first payment of an amount in respect of which the agreement is effect, which is made or after the first. status, determination, date, January the 1st, May the 1st, July the 1st, and October the 1st of each year. That actually occurs at least 30 days after the date on which the notice is furnished. If the employee executes a new W-4 form, the request upon which the agreement under Section 3402 Papa is based shall be attached and constitute as part such a new W-4. So brothers and sisters, in my conclusion of this video, employers who hire employees who do not have a social security number need to adjust their policies, because the Internal Revenue Service, according to what we just covered, withholding policies requires employees who complete this form to provide a taxpayer identification number, a TIN, or a social security number. So the form W-4 actually becomes a binding withholding agreement when it is actually completed by an employee and accepted by the employer. So once an employee volunteers to enter into a withholding agreement with the employer actually accepts the agreement, then the employer becomes legally obligated to withhold and pay the taxes due. There is no legal authority to withhold, nor is there any obligation in the absence of this agreement. Do you understand? Do you understand? So, although there is no law, employers should advise employees who do not complete a W-4 that they will be responsible for paying due taxes. These employees should be asked to sign a statement such as the following, showing that they do not wish to enter a voluntary withholding agreement, and they understand that they lose their entitlement to certain government benefits. Do you understand? Now, the next video, I'll go into the W-4T, voluntary withholding agreement. And with that, brothers and sisters, I'm going to bring this one to a close, and I trust that you gathered something resourceful from this video. I know initially I started off talking about our interpersonal relationships, because I actually been getting message from several brothers and sisters that's actually been going through some really harsh, hectic situations. Just want to tell you to hang in there and remain strong. Think positive thoughts. Learn this and you will be unstoppable. So again, if you found this video to be of value, kindly click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this video to be worth. If you need some type of direction or education with some sort of commercial presentment, please click the email link below or contact me at creditorsdebtorscontracts@yahoo.com, and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. Or if you would like to become a secured party creditor, email me as well. So until next time, Tazik Doc is signing off. So I say shalom, shalom, yashallah, peace and blessings be upon you all. Shalom.